Whether you're working Instacart part-time or full-time, consider it both your preferred and minimum total earnings in a week. Now take those numbers and divide them by the number of hours you've scheduled or willing to work if you're in an on-demand zone. The answers will result in your wage range, with a higher number being your preferred wage and a lower number being your personal minimum wage. Let me give you an example. Say you're doing Instacart part-time and your goal is to make $200 a week, and you're willing to work 9 hours on the weekend and one weeknight shift of 4 hours. So if we divide $200 by 13 hours, that comes out to just over $15 an hour, which is a fairly realistic goal. If you're willing to settle for $150 a week by working the same number of hours, your minimum hourly wage is $11.53. Does this mean you should automatically accept every batch paying $11.53 or higher and reject anything paying less? Basically, yes. But there are a few things you need to consider. First of all, when you complete a batch, there's no guarantee you will have another one lined up right away. Any downtime between batches means the next job will have to pay more to make up for the time you lost between gigs. For example, let's say you accept a $15 batch and complete it in an hour, but then 30 minutes goes by with no work to do. If you're just sitting around, you're not making any money. In order to make up for that downtime, the next batch would have to pay $22.50 so that you're still averaging $15 an hour, and this goes on for the entire week. Second of all, most batches take about an hour to complete, but small batches can sometimes be knocked out in 20 minutes or less, while really large batches can take 70, 80, or 90 plus minutes. The number of items, as well as the total mileage involved, all factor into the time. But how can you accurately estimate those variables? I'll show you how in the next few sections. If you know what your average shopping speed is, you can use that to estimate the bulk of the labor with simple math. Look at the item count, then multiply that by your average item time. If you don't know your exact speed, err on the side of caution and just say 1 minute per item, which is about average for new shoppers. Seasoned shoppers like me can slash their time down to about 30 seconds an item. Additionally, it takes about 5 to 7 minutes to complete the checkout process. Walking back to the car and loading it up takes about another 5 to 7 minutes. So to estimate the total shopping time, multiply your shopping speed by the number of items and add 5 to 10 minutes to account for the complete and total shopping time. In the case of delivery-only orders, the time you'll spend at the store is obviously much shorter. If it's only a few bags, you can probably scan them and be out the door in a matter of minutes. But if it's a large double or triple batch, it can sometimes take 10 to 20 minutes to scan the bags, put them in insulated bags, and then load up your car. As I said before, there are a few variables to consider when looking over a batch offer. Made-to-order items play a huge role in determining a batch's worth. Having to order deli or prepared foods can increase your shopping time by 5 to 10 minutes or 20-something minutes in a worst-case scenario. If there's a long line and only one person working the counter, that can totally screw you. This is why you should always scroll through the preview pictures and look for those kinds of items before you accept a batch. Another X factor to consider is the store itself. How busy is it on average? How busy is it right now? How bad is the traffic? How long are the lines usually? How competent is the staff? Is there a better store in the vicinity? If so, it might actually be worth to go there if you know that store will be quicker and easier. Mileage is an important factor to consider when analyzing the batch offer screen. Instacart indicates the mileage from the store to the customer, but not the distance from where you are to the store. Sometimes you'll be offered a batch that seems worthwhile, but then you realize it's for a store 10 or 15 miles away. You can shop at a closer store if it's partnered and save yourself some time, but bear in mind, Instacart will probably not adjust the mileage compensation. Another thing to consider is the customer's location. The store might be close, but the customer might be out in the middle of nowhere. Once you complete the delivery, how far and for how long will you have to deadhead back to civilization? Speaking of dead miles, Instacart has a terrible habit of sending delivery-only orders to stores 20 or 30 miles away from the customer when there are literally dozens of stores closer to them. So you might see a tempting, high-paying batch for a nearby store only to realize it's taking you 10 cities away. If the customer is in an area with other Instacart stores nearby, you might be able to grab another batch out there when you're done. But you're going to have to make your way home eventually. If it's in the middle of the day, you could only accept orders heading in your general direction. But if it's later in the evening, you might have to eat all those miles going home. A lot of new shoppers naively take low-item, low-mileage batches, thinking they can knock out two or three of them in an hour. After all, if you complete three $7 batches or two $9 batches in an hour, that's the equivalent of making $21 or $18 an hour. If you could do that all day, you'd be making pretty good money, right? No, it doesn't work like that. You can't approach Instacart as you would DoorDash, Uber Eats, or Grubhub. Low-item, low-mileage batches are rare, and being offered many of them in a row, let alone an entire shift, is completely unrealistic. Not even delivery-only batches are comparable because the mileage tends to be way higher than it is with hot food delivery. Worst of all, when you take low-ball batches, you teach the algorithm that you're willing to work for peanuts, and I'll explain what this means later in the video. The most obvious warning sign of a bad batch is plus no tip. I cannot stress this enough. Do not accept batches without an upfront tip. You can do the best job in the world, but that won't change the fact that some customers absolutely refuse to tip. Believe me, I've done over 1,200 batches this year, and whenever a batch said plus no tip, it almost always stayed that way. I'd say maybe 1 in 50 customers who don't tip upfront tip at the door or after delivery. So you can hope and pray that that will happen to you, but the odds are not on your side. You've probably heard that what you see on Facebook is determined by an algorithm that learns your habits and purposely tries to show you what it thinks you want to see. Well, the algorithm Instacart uses to assign batches works on essentially the same concept of machine learning. For every batch that you accept, you teach the algorithm what you consider to be an acceptable payment for the time, mileage, and physical labor. So if you accept a lot of batches paying $9, Instacart will think that's the kind of batches you prefer, and you'll be offered more and more batches like that. When enough people do this in mass, it brings wages down across the board. I'll do an entire video explaining this another time, but for now, just realize that when it comes to your Instacart payments, whatever you allow is what will continue. So just to recap, when it comes to determining if a batch is worth it or not, calculate your preferred and minimum earnings and wages. Look over each batch carefully and try to predict how long it will take to complete. Consider the subtle nuances and various X factors associated with the batch. Don't equate Instacart labor to simple food delivery labor. Avoid red flags and be careful what you teach the algorithm. Hopefully this video explained the basics of what goes into accepting or rejecting a batch. It really doesn't take too long before you'll be able to look at a batch offer and make a quick decision. If you disagree with any of my points or you think I left something out, let me know in the comments section. As always, I encourage you to check out my library of Instacart and gig economy videos. If you're new here, why not subscribe so you don't miss any of my future installments? Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.